Hello students, this is Priyanka Bagchi from SBM Cinedi, and today I will discuss transformation of sentences from affirmative to negative and how to deal with it. For this, there are some rules and today I'm going to discuss them. So, as in this PPT, I have already shown some rules of transformation from affirmative to negative sentence, where in order to change an affirmative sentence having an auxiliary verb with a verb or an adjective or an adverb into a negative sentence, we should add not after the auxiliary verb and use the opposite of the verb or the adjective or the adverb in negative sentence. We should not always try to change the meaning of the sentence to make it a negative one. This is already written here. You can see that here everything is written and two examples are also given. I shall remember you. Okay, so this is the subject, this is the auxiliary verb, this is the verb, and this is the extension. Okay, and what I wrote here, you see, I shall not forget you means subject, auxiliary verb, I added not here, and then I made the opposite of this verb remember and wrote here forget. So according to the rule, what I just said and here we have already written also, so the sentence is absolutely correct. Coming to the next page, here also you can see in this boxes there are few rules which are explained very beautifully. And now come to this page, the rules I will discuss one by one. I will take one sentence to make the example more clear. I shall remember you. So this is an affirmative sentence and we can make it a negative one in two ways. So the first is, I shall not remember you. I shall not remember you. This sentence is also a correct one, but the problem is that this sentence completely changed the meaning. I shall remember you, I shall not remember you. It is also a negative sentence. So when the question will be asked that change into negative, change the affirmative sentence into negative without changing its meaning, then you have to opt for the next way. So the next sentence, the same sentence, make it into negative is, I shall not forget you. That means according to the structure, the subject is there, the auxiliary verb is there, and then we used the negative word not, and then we used the V1 form, the opposite of the word remember, the verb. As in the definition I said that if the sentence carrying an auxiliary verb or and a verb or an adjective or an adverb, we have to use the opposite meaning of those particular words. So coming to the next rule, the next rule is, if the affirmative structure is subject, subject plus auxiliary verb plus verb or adjective or adverb plus extension of the sentence. If this is the structure, the sentence is I shall remember you. I shall remember you. Okay. So in order to exchange an affirmative sentence having an in order to exchange an affirmative sentence having an auxiliary verb with a verb or adjective or an adverb into a negative sentence we add not after the auxiliary verb and opposite meaning of verb or adjective or adverb in the negative sentence okay. So the structure is now subject plus auxiliary verb plus not plus opposite of verb or adjective or adverb plus extension so the sentence will be as I shall not forget you. Now come to the next rule. If the affirmative sentence structure is as subject plus verb plus extension. You see, there is no auxiliary verb in this structure. The sentence is she remembered me. Okay. So, to deal with such kind of sentence, if there is no auxiliary verb in, affirmative sentence, then we use to do verb and as auxiliary verb to make it a auxiliary verb to make it a negative sentence. After to do verb to make it a negative sentence. After to do verb negative sentence. After to do verb not will be used. Not will be used and the opposite of the verb will be used. Okay, so this to do verb will be according to the tense of the verb of affirmative sentence. Now I will take one sentence. First I will write the structure: subject plus auxiliary verb plus to do verb plus not plus opposite V1 plus extension. Opposite V1 plus extension of the sentence. So, as I wrote the sentence affirmative, she remembered me. The next sentence, negative sentence, will be as she did not forget me. So, this did come. Did, the word did is the to do verb. This we made as auxiliary verb and we used the not after this and then changed the meaning. We put the opposite meaning of the word remember. As I said that the tense of the verb will be according to the tense of the verb of affirmative sentence. So that's why it was remember in the affirmative sentence and now it became forget. And it was remembered and it is not forgot because we have already used the to do verb which is did and according to the tense of the sentence. Okay. Now coming to the next rule. Related to the, now the rules we are going to discuss, the rules are related to the use of the word only. So, if the situation is this way, only or alone plus person, the negative will be, then it is the affirmative form. The negative will be none but plus person and extension. None but plus person plus extension. This is the one case. The next case with the word only. Sentences. The next case is only plus thing in affirmative, the negative will be as nothing but plus thing plus extension plus thing plus extension. These are the rules, you must remember these things. The third case is only plus numbers or weight. Only plus numbers or weight. In affirmative, the negative is not more or less than number or weight. Or weight. These are the three situations with the use of only or alone. So we must remember that only is used before the person and alone is used after the person, word and auxiliary verb. Okay, the structures are as only plus subject plus verb plus extension. Extension, it is the affirmative structure. Affirmative structure it is. So the sentence I will put here, only God can help us. So here we can see after only, it is the presence of person, God. Okay, so the negative structure will be as for this statement, structure will be as for this statement, none but God can help us. As in the previous page I have already said that only, and after that if the presence of person, then none but will be used. Okay, now the situation is that the next structure is with the use of the word alone. So the affirmative structure is as subject plus auxiliary verb plus alone plus extension. So the sentence affirmative is, he was alive alone in the house. Alone in the house. So the negative sentence for this affirmative is, none but he was alone, alive in the house. As in the rule I have already said that alone is used in the house. That I have already said that alone is used after the person, okay, and word auxiliary verb. So this was the person, he, and this is the was auxiliary verb, and after that alone is used. This way the structure is done. Few more sentences I will give according to this rule, that only Radha writes to me. Only Radha writes to me. This is the affirmative. And the negative of this sentence is, none but Radha writes to me. The meaning is changed. The sentence became from affirmative to negative without changing its meaning. None but Radha writes to me. Did not change the tense, but change the sentence only without changing the meaning. One more sentence. Raman likes rice and curry. This is the affirmative form. The negative of this sentence is, Raman likes nothing but rice and curry. Raman likes nothing but rice and curry. You can again see that the meaning is same, but the sentence is changed. One more sentence for this. Veena is only Veena is only 10. Means Veena is 10 years old. Veena is only 10. This is the affirmative form, and the negative of this is, Veena is not more or less than 10. So you can see very beautifully I dealt with all the three forms, like if the only comes with the person, then none but. If the word only and after that thing, nothing but. And if the word only and after that numbers or weight, that would be more or less and then than. So all the sentences are beautifully dealt in this rule. Now come to the next rule. The rule is, if we have must, has to, if we have in a sentence, in an affirmative sentence, if we have must, has to, have to, or can, the negative sentence will be as. The negative sentence will be as. There will be two conditions. One is can't but plus P1. Another is can't help plus V1 plus ING. Okay, this situation is only when we have in the affirmative sentence, we have must or has to or have to or can. One more situation can come. If we have had to or could in affirmative sentence, the negative sentence will be as, to or could in affirmative sentence, the negative sentence will be as couldn't but plus V1. Couldn't but plus V1. This is the one structure, and the next structure can be couldn't help plus V1 plus ing. As it was in the case of must, has to, have to, can, this was can't but plus V1, can't help plus V1 plus ing. When it is, we have in the sentence, we have had to or could, the negative would be couldn't but plus V1, couldn't help plus V1 plus ing. So, the examples are, he must attend the class. You can see, we have must in the sentence. He must attend the class. So, the probable change of negative is he can't but attend the class. He can't but attend the class. And the next probability is he can't help attending the class. You can see that we had must in the sentence and how we changed it. Now, next example, we have to go to school. Have to. Now we have to in the sentence. We have to go to school. You must know what will be the negative form. Yes, we can't but go to school. The meaning is same, the sentence is changed. And the next probability is we can't help going to school. That means V1 plus ing. Going to school. Okay, another example. Anokhi can join the meeting. This is the affirmative form, and we are having can in the sentence, and we will change it into negative. Anokhi can't but join the meeting. The meaning is same, the sentence is changed. Without changing its meaning, we are transforming the sentence. Anokhi can't but join the meeting. And the next probability is Anokhi can't help joining the meeting. Okay, so all the cases with must, has to, have to, and can we have used. Now one is left, the use of had to. So the next example is Raju had to work very hard. So the change is first with couldn't but. The Raju, negative form, Raju couldn't but work very hard. This is the negative of the affirmative. without changing the meaning. Very hard. And the next probability is Raju couldn't help working very hard. Raju couldn't help working very hard. So the formula was couldn't help plus B1 plus ing. And the use was had to in the sentence. This way all the affirmative sentences are changed to negative but without changing its meaning. One more rule I will discuss today. The next is, if we have statement as both dot 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 and dot dot dot, or dot 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 and dot 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 in affirmative sentence. If we have this situation in affirmative sentence, so in negative sentence we will write this way: not only dot 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 but also dot dot dot. So here in these dots we can use the words like if both x, means we can use both x and y, both x and y, or if the sentence is x and y, I am saying here you can, we will use the subjects, the nouns. Okay, so both x and y, or x and y, if the sentence formation is this, so we will write not only x but also y while changing it into negative. Okay, so the examples are: both you and he will go there. You can see both and two subjects are here. Both you and he will go there. This is the affirmative form. And the negative of this, using this not only but also, is as: not only you but also he will go there. But also he will go there. This is the negative form. Means the meaning is same, but the sentence is transformed from affirmative to negative. The next example is: he is handsome and intelligent. He is handsome and intelligent. You have to mind it, people, that the words must be joined with and there only we will use the use of not only but also. So he is handsome and intelligent. Okay, so the use in the negative form is as: he is not only handsome but also intelligent. But also intelligent. So almost so many rules have been discussed, and I think this much for today. Next day again I will come with some other rules. This much for now. Goodbye, students.